Easy for you, by step, there you go. Stand up deep before you go up. Spot up, there you go. Good job. You know how to take a deep breath? Deep breath, just spot up. Spot up, spot up, you get it. Spot up, deep breath, let's go down and up. Nice, right, good job. Good work, good work, good work. Let's ride out just a little about probably 3 minutes just to get loosened up. How did that feel?
Good.
I look good. What I want you to do on both of them, heading over there, especially over here, I want you to spot up, keep your head up, make sure you spot up, don't drop it even. And I want you to make sure, I want to hear, before you go down, I want to hear that deep breath coming in. As you're going up, I want to hear that, I want to hear you empty it. Let me know that you're staying tight with it. See, because sometimes you can get bent over and you get hunched over because of your diaphragm is not, and your lungs aren't fully, you know what I'm saying, inhaled, and you don't have that weight belt, your natural weight belt going on. Or you can get bent over because your back is weak or whatever. Okay. And so the only way that I can tell the difference is if I hear the breath come in and if I hear it come out. So I want to hear the deep breath. Over here was a great, great fit. I was behind, so it's kind of, I'll see it on film, but it looked good. But once again, same thing over here, I want to hear, before you go down, you know what I'm saying? I want to hear you suck it in real deep. Hold it down the bottom. Blow out. Hold it down just like you're about to try to poop. Hold it down. And blow out at the top. What that's going to do is going to keep you tighter, and it's going to allow you to build your core a lot better. It's going to allow you to allow you to get a lot heavier, allow you to build legs a lot quicker. That breath is so important. Where did it lead off at?
Let's six. See. I started at six.
Okay. Let's go into nine. Okay. This time we're gonna go lateral. So we're gonna bring our feet in close. Straight ahead. Same thing. Deep breath. Yeah, you got it. You got it. Stay calm. Don't rush. Stay calm. Don't rush. Sometimes you get excited in the moment and you're rushing, you know what I'm saying? I can feel the excitedness. And that's usually going to throw your breathing off, and that's going to throw your core off too. You know what I mean?
Are we going that low?
Yeah, you going that low. What you mean? Did you come to me? This is the land, you see where he at? This is the land of the low squat. I'm going to tell you why we go that low. I'm going to be honest. Because it actually helps with our ligaments and our joints. It helps with flexibility. It helps with keeping us youthful. It helps with longevity. I'd rather go low and go lighter than to go heavy. Stay up here because you don't get range of motion. Sometimes we will go heavy. If we're going for power, we're going for heavy. Yeah, let's just do a box fight. It's just a parallel. With these, we work range of motion. So I work complete body. That's why I work on elongating the muscles. I work on ligament. I work on the bounce. I work on hip flexors, you know. So that's why we do that. So we challenge that. Whenever you're ready. Stay tight with it. Start with your feet together. Always start with your base.
Yeah.
Yep, always start with your base. I don't care what you're doing. Then adjust as you get your deep breath. Don't try to set your feet and take your bar off. First thing first. One, two, three. Good job. Then you set your feet. Do your spotting. And get that deep breath. Deep breath. There you go. That's better. Deep breath. That's where it is. Good job. Deep breath. Good job. Three more. Deep breath. Yep. Beautiful. Deep breath. One more. Deep breath. Nice. Beautiful work. Come up. Come up. Come up. Good job. Great work.
Same here?
Nope. These stay wide. These staying up. But let me hear that deep breath. I don't want to see that forward tilt. I don't want to see your core collapse. So let me hear that deep breath. I know you got it. I know you're more than strong enough to get it. And spot up. So when you get ready, spot up. Should be deep breath. Nice. Blow out of here. Deep breath. Spot up. Deep breath. Good job. Spot up. Deep breath. There you go.
Good job. Deep breath, spine up. Good job. Way to work. Good job. Beautiful work. Good job. Good work. That's beautiful. No bobbles, no forward. Ass down. Good bounce out of there. Core look good. Abdominals look good. Let's do about another. Let's go out to. Let's go another 3 minutes. How'd that feel?
Good.
That looked really good. Oh, wasn't too heavy. You're up to something wrong. We're going low like that with that.
That's the first time I've ever done squats with that leg like that.
Yeah. This time we're doing pirouette or a sumo. So. Point it out. My leg fried. Right now. My legs are fried. You are an animal. Great job. It's great set. Great set. When we get done with this last one, I'm going to bring it up one clip. We're going to go overload on that, meaning I'm going to make it heavier and leg extensions. So we just going to go forward and be like box squats. We'll bring it up. Yep, yep. We're going to overload after we pre-fatigue them. Hopefully, to get more into the V2 muscle fibers and the other fibers already pre-fatigue after going through this, writing everything. So hopefully, we don't have to go super, 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 super heavy to get what we would normally get super, super, super heavy early. You understand what I'm saying? Early, we would have to go super, super, super heavy. But now, because we did this and we're working different angles of it and stuff, we can get heavy overload with box squats and get the same results that if we started off going super, super heavy, deep and everything else. So we're just working in reverse. It's the same way like when I showed you how to do the stiff leg deadlifts in reverse. Let's ride out. Let's keep riding. Let's ride out. Let's ride out to 12 out of 13. Make sure that you're nice and rest. This one, this one was in this one. That's my fourth fit of that.
Yeah. Now, why do you do with the arms like that?
For crossfit and to work my core over here squats, I do close to 300 over my head. Then I go into a single arm swing. This is explosion. I'm working explosion and crossfit, you know, related movements. So I do a single arm at 60.
I have a friend.
Yeah, it's beastly. And then you'll see after I get done with the single arm swings. Watch what I go back and do. Then I go ass to heels bounces just for ligaments, just for tendon ligaments, an explosion out of movements where you're doing like cleans and snatches and stuff. So, let's see.
No.
30 bounces. And then explode out of this. That's the beginning of my workout. And then this one right here. The end of the workout. 500 10 pound dumbbell box jump. Yeah, that's what I just got to do more.
That's CrossFit?
It's related because of the explosive, but it's a plyometric movement with weight. And then I stretch out my hamstrings, stretch out my lower back, over my core, all the way to floor pass, curl over my hand. Yeah, people look like I'm crazy. Alright, fix it. So if I look like I'm tired and you see what I was grimacing when I was up underneath here, that's why. So pirouette, so remember, every time you always go with your base. Every time you lift, you charge your base, and then you walk into it. You get your spot, deep breath, and get out. Ready? One, two, three. So okay. There you go. Base, pirouette, feet out. Five, deep breath. Nice. Good job. Ready? You got it. Get down. Yep. Good job. Deep breath. Two more. Come on. Deep breath. Come on. One more. Deep breath. Blow it out of there. Good job. And in there. Good job. Great work.
Now, we're not overloading here. We're getting deep. I want the bounce. We're going ligament tissue. But I also want that. I also want that air and that fighting up there, too. So I don't want to see no bend. Deep breath. Nice. Everything like that. Deep breath. Nice, good spotting. Deep breath. Three more like that. Good job. Deep breath. Two more like that. Deep breath. Nice. Deep breath. Nice. Don't get bent over on there. Don't rush. Don't rush to the rack. Stay in control. Remember what we said? 10 seconds afterwards. You rush it at the end. Don't rush the end of it.
Enjoy the
finish. So we're gonna go overload, I'm gonna bring it up.
And I'm actually gonna put a little bit over 200 on it. You got it. Neutral stance. Big breath, you got it. See, the reason why people don't push themselves is because they don't know when to push themselves or how they push themselves. You got four of these. Right for 2.5 minutes, stop, grab a drink of water. You got four with 2-0. I think it's we'll go 165 for 4. 50 45 95 for 70 60. Before, and if I like it, we'll go up. You got it. Remember, deep breath in is overload, so go really get at it. So we go forward here, we're gonna come out here, rep out. Once you lean back, stay at a good rep pace. Good rhythm, good breathing. We'll go rep it out. So 2.5. Okay. You grab a quick drink. If not, let's have you take a minute to get yourself, get your core, get your energy ready to go. And then let's get after it. You got it. This
Can
is
we
like.
Do some more after that?
Huh?
Are you more adult?
No. Nah, I ain't kidding. Come on now. I ain't over training. We want four here, then we rep it here. Then we're gonna do one more sit here, then we rip it here. Then we're gonna do boom. So I got a pillow to put down the hamstrings where you pull out in the push up, you push yourself off, come up to work your hamstrings. You do that and we'll do some core twists, and then you'll be out of here. So. So if you want to drink, if you want to get yourself relaxed, you're ready. Big core, you got it. It's light, stay big. Deep breath, drive up. Let me know if you feel anything, you know what I'm saying, weird. But you got it, I know you got it. It's lightweight. You should be doing 200 at this box squat. Call death right here. More than strong enough. Animal, let's get after it. These are your goals. Big sit on three. One, two, three. These are your goals. Big breath, fight it up.
Let's go. Out. Come on. Easy. Come on. Up. Two. Come on. Three. One more. Up. Bring it down. Oh, bring it up. Bring it up.
I told you that was going to be too late. You're looking at me like I'm crazy. All right, let's blast them out. Match your breathing with it. Keep them up. Keep them extended. Stay on the same pace. Match your breathing and pace. Good job.
Get your chest up. Get your chest up. There you go. Get that corner gap. There you go. There you go. Good job.
Stand control of it.
Five, four, three, two, one more. Good job. Good job. One more rotation of that. Great work. Great work. No, no, no. You ain't going back over here. You got a rep.
You thought it was. Who are you? Who are you, Superwoman? You got another 3 minute rest. It's all about recovery. It's all about being at full strength when we're doing that. This is recovery. We don't. That's a precursor to an injury to jump back in there.
When you got the overload like that, we don't do that. You know what I'm saying? Even though it would challenge your cardiovascular, and I do that, but it's a sure way that you is more than likely to go injure yourself because you're already tapped into that muscle system and you need some recovery time. All right, so we got another 3 minutes. We're gonna go 200 in the last 2 weeks. I'm just interested in seeing you do 200 because I know you ain't every day. I know you don't trust yourself. I'm just kind of interested, but I don't know if I want to go right now. And I'm not worried about you getting the weight, because I know you're going to get the weight. The only thing that I want to make sure is that when you take it off, be confident, spot up, get your set, deep breath, and stay in it. The weight is going to be easy. That's the easy part. I'm not worried about the weight going up and down. I just want to make sure, the only reason why I'm not jumping, don't want to really jump all the way and go, 60, 70, 80. All right, let's go 190. We'll go 190. You won't go 200. I'll lay that one later today. Know where you're going here, but I know you can get it, and I don't want to cheat you to do box squat overload. Core stretch yourself. You got it. Aggressive, big. So it's, listen. When you get off of it, when you get over there, make sure you do a mini squat. Get yourself situated. Spot up. Don't think about the weight. Spot up. Big breath. Lead yourself down. Stay tight with it. Blow out when you get to the top. You got four of them. Easy four. All right, go ahead and give yourself a few minutes to grab a drink before walking through. Stand up. Get your mind right. Let's go. You cross over here. Be ready. You got it. Lightweight. You got it. Don't let it intimidate you. Listen. You got this. You got it. You know I'm going to get this up. Go. You got a spotter. This is where you challenge yourself. When you got somebody that you know what to do. This is where you push yourself when you get after it. It's yourself. You understand what I'm saying? I'm all this way out because I know you can do it four times. Not because I think you can do it. Because there's no doubt in my mind that you can do it. But you got to know you can do it, okay? You got it. I know you got it. Easy way. Stay big. Stay tight with it. Lightweight. Be confident. Be a tight. Let me know on three and we lift it off. Ready? One, two, three. Chin up, chest up. Five. Let's go, bro. Come on, you got it. Easy right. Up. Good job. Up. Up. One more. Big breath. Up. Line. And it's easy like that. Easy like Sunday morning.
Easy like Sunday morning. I see. Welcome to your new milestone.
Your new standard. Let it work. Breathe. Now get under control. That's a good day to go.
Good job. Stay in there, same rhythm. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time. Good job. Number right. Grab a drink. Got a little quick thing. We're doing some hamstring work. Great work. I told you, I mean. That's why I get paid to do the evaluations and to put people out there where I know they could go. You understand what I'm saying? They put people out there in places that they don't know that they're ready to go to yet. You ain't never done that in your life.
No.
First time working with me, all it was pressure. You did it easy. You probably would have never done it if nobody would have made you jump out there and do it. You probably would have stayed in your comfort zone. But you're more than strong enough. I told you got that. And I've seen it. And I knew you had it. So what it is that you do, that you put your knees on the pillow, and then you put your feet underneath it right here. So your knees on the pillow and your feet go underneath the bar. So you, and then you go like you're about to do a push-up. No, you got it. That's why I'm smashing. You got it around. There you go. Put your hands up. Yeah, like you're about to do a push-up. Come down to a push-up. There you go. And then you push up. There you go. There you go. There you go. Nice. Good job. Good hamstring work. Nice. Good job. Boy, that's this is how you work your hamstring without working your lower back. It's a dominant muscle. So really get the hamstring to that. 3 more. 2 more. 1 more. Good job. Great job. Great work. But you never done them before either, huh?
Nope.
I got you doing all kinds of like, what the heck you got me doing? Let's go ahead and knock off some abs combo. Some crunches. So we're going to the rubber capacity. Shoot the ball up, hold the ball. Shoot it for this spot in the wall. Try to touch this spot. I'm going to take this. Now keep it up. No. Oh. Oh, crunch up and reach up for it. There you go. Just about right here on the wall. And then you can touch. Good job. Make sure you breathe. Good job.
That'll work.
Keep your arms extended. There you go. There you go. There you go. There you go. Good work, y'all. Way to work. There you go. So play it. 5, 4, 3, 2, time. Good job. Grab a quick drink. Come back over your hands. Good work.
Great work.
Great leg day. Good ab day. Beautiful day. ain't you like it? Like you done did a whole day's worth of work, huh?
For real.
Hey, that's how we do it here. This is how we get after it. You got your maximum, you got your maximum rest that you need. You got your recovery time. Ain't no, we cut the fat off, ain't no BSing. We get that you can get recovered so we can get on to the next muscle. I don't play around. This is how we do it. Yeah, you know what I'm saying, huh? Especially, you know what I mean? Especially when you look good, you don't have to spend no hours. Sometimes it takes longer because we got to change during duration, but it really ain't really that long. 40 minutes is usually max. All right, let's get out. Good job. Nice. Good job. Great work. Good breathing. Good work. Good job. Great work. Good job. Good job. Good job. 6 more. Let's go. Let's get 12. 5, 4, good work. 3, 2, 1 more. Let's see. Back over here on the abs. That's it. 1 more rotation at that. Good work. Good work.
Shoot for the. Reach up for the target. Stay calm in it. Match your breathing in it. Contract at the top of the skin.
Yeah. Good job. Way to work. Good job.
Tuesday calm, Tuesday calm, Tuesday calm, Tuesday calm, no rushing, Tuesday calm, one stay calm, done, good job. Have another drink, one more rotation. All right, great job. And that's the reason why we're doing hamstrings like this now, because you have overload because we're going deep on your back. And so the other hamstring or stiff leg will work your lower back, and your lower back will be a dominant muscle. This way, you work it from down to up where your back is taken out of it, so it's all glutes and hamstrings. So it develops a nice butt, good hamstrings. I mean, that's why I'm the mad scientist in here. I done
experienced, done, experiment.
We just about everything, the different ways to reach muscles, touch muscles, stimulate it, get over it. And we're talking about just adding about another, we really did about 240 pounds. Just add about another 40 pounds of resistance and put the band on it. Yeah. And you never would have just went out there on that on your own, you know what I mean? And most trainers probably wouldn't even put you out there because they wouldn't have seen that you could do that and you had that in you. Good job, great job. Last rotation, get me out of here. Let's get after it. One, good job. Good work. Two, good job. Three, good job. Four, good job. Five, good job. Four, three, good work. Two, one more, good job. Good job, way not to rush out of it. Way to slow play. Way to run it good. Get this last half one in. That's the dance. You got it.
Great work today. Beautiful work. Let's get after it.
Good work. Good job. Good work. But it's okay. Good job. Good job. Great job. Enjoy the journey. Good job. Five, four, three, two, one more.
That's it. That's the workout, Miss Lady. Was that 30 minutes?
Yes, sir.
30 minutes in and out like a robber.
We're like 28.
30 minutes, that's a great, great, great job today.
Way to get after it.